If you guys have a late model GM truck and your spare tire's stuck, there's an easy way to remove it. So this is the part that gets stuck. So this hook over here, you can see there's a short end over here, and you can see the hook that comes out. So when this goes up, it pushes out, and it goes and hangs on inside of here, inside the winch system. So this is it when it's pushed in. Now, what you have to do is just put your screwdriver all the way up through here and push on it, and that'll release it.
So you guys see here, because we have a bigger diameter tire, it kind of gets on the safety latch all the time. So if you guys are running bigger tires and you have a trailer hitch, it's pulling off an angle, that's going to do it. So you can see the boot there. You can get the screwdriver onto it to move it.
So try and give you guys an idea how I did it. So when it was loose, you kind of want to reel it back up, because we're simulating you being in the middle of nowhere. Now, if you were at home, put straps on this or have friend or two help you hold the tire. If you're in the middle of nowhere, you're by yourself, this is how you're gonna have to do it. So if you notice it's not coming down, put the cable back up and get this cable close to here, because it's already come down a bunch. It's already come down as far as it can. And what you're gonna have to do, you know, exercise extreme caution, because I find you have to be underneath the tire for this. So if you're not comfortable doing it, you'll have to just call, you know, roadside assistance. You will have enough room if you push the tire up with your forearms. So you'll support the weight with your forearms on both sides. I'm holding the camera and both my forearms are on the tire. And then you can come up and release it. And you'll feel the weight come down onto you. So, you know, don't have your face underneath. You don't want to chip a bunch of your teeth. But this is how I was able to get it out. So it was like, okay, if I was on the side of the road, how would I get this out? I didn't have to remove their license plate or anything. So there will be enough room. You can push the boot up as well, and you can see it. So you will be able to lift this up and rotate it. When it's down, you can't. So I can rotate it if I push up with my arms, and I can see the orientation of where I need to put my screwdriver. I can push on it. It'll come down nice and easy, and just be very, very careful if you're going to do it this way. I suggest that you guys run straps in your vehicle regardless, in case ever, you know, you're picking something up and you have straps here ready to go. So if you have straps in your truck at all times, then you can use that to help hold the spare tire up instead of trying to use your forearms. To maintain under the truck, we like to use, in this case, we typically use fluid film or crown. So for this part, we're going to use crown, and I've sprayed the mechanism and I've sprayed inside the winch, because let's be honest, how often do we check this? We should be checking it every... In a perfect world, you're checking it every 4 months, at least before any road trip, you're seeing if this works, or checking it, you know, at least annually, at the bare minimum. You know, make sure that this system works, because if this doesn't work and you're in the middle of nowhere, you're going to be hooped pretty much. So we will oil it, put it back up, and then, you know, you don't have to worry about it for like a year. So another thing we need to make sure we do when we lock it, you hear that click. That helps the whole assembly. So what we noticed is if you don't do that click and then you lower it, it tends to want to lock more often. Because a lot of the times when we lower it, if it gets a little bit stuck, we just give it a good kick and it will drop. And we've done it a few times. So what we noticed is when we actually lock it, because sometimes you might just say, okay, it's snug, you're done. That's what's inducing the problem of it doing the safety lock. With your security lock, also take the time to lubricate the inside, that way it doesn't get sticky. If you never lubricate and it gets wet in here and it gets really cold, it can ice up. So if you spray something in here designed for locks, you'll never have an icing issue. So hopefully, guys, that helps you out. This is an item you guys should be looking at and just oiling it up. There's nothing else, there's no adjustments you have to make, but you want to do inspections, make sure everything is in good condition, especially for those of you that live in areas where they salt a lot. With all the mist of all the salt in the, if the road is wet and then there's salt on the road and it's misting up into the frame, you know, these parts are yet really rusted, and when you need it the most, it's not going to be able to help you out. So take it down every year, inspect it, oil it up, put it back up, inspect it for proper operation. That way when you do need it, it's going to work for you.